It can feel like the climate is changing faster than we can react, but there are people doing good work. There is a Climate Crew.
One of the things we're hoping to learn about deer is how they move through this landscape. So this work is critically important to understanding how those home ranges are likely going to change in response to climate change and how we need to adapt our management practices to better address the impacts of climate change.
Management practices are actions such as ecological monitoring, managing wildlife populations, restoring forests, and designing park roads to reduce their impact on wildlife. The Climate Crew start by baiting the traps to attract the deer.
Let's get this camera up and we can track when the deer are moving into the trap.
So that'll send a signal every time there's a deer?
Yeah, anytime there's any activity, it'll send us a photo. Whether it's a deer or any other animal walking by, we'll be able to pick it up and get it sent to our phone or our iPad.
A unique part of the research that we're doing with Trent University is they have a lot of experience working on wildlife movement, wildlife genetics, and big mammal biology. They're recognized experts in the country.
So what we do is we put these neat little radio collars on deer, and they send us a location every 2 hours. And so we get a really detailed understanding of their movement behaviors and how they're interacting with one another.
The collars are programmed to fall off in about 2 years, but if needed, the team can release them remotely.
I think it's just up this way.
Collars can be found by the radio signal they emit and reprogram.
You're fine.
To be used again.
The way we handle deer in such a short amount of time without drugs is also less stressful on the animal. And so they're able to recover much quicker.
So this eye mask for them keeps them pretty calm. If their eyes are covered, a lot of wild animals will be relaxed like this, which is why we do it. Cover their ears too, just to limit how much external noise they're getting.
You want to give me the drop-off code?
3, lowercase d, frequency 171.
Okay.
Give me the tape measure. He is 25 and a half at the smallest.
We do hind foot. It's good overall measure of body size because we can't weigh these animals. But so we're measuring their hind foot length, and it's just an overall pretty good metric.
44 and a half.
Do we have a hair sample?
From tissue and hair samples, the team can determine the age, health, and genetic traits of the deer.
Part of the project with Thousand Islands is getting a sense of how potentially new pathogens or diseases could enter the population of deer in Ontario.
Buck fawn, collar 48, frequency 171, 140, magnet's been removed.
Correct. Okay, now we do it in reverse.
Yeah. Ticks.
Anytime you guys are ready.
Yep.
Okay, I'm good.
Yep.
3, 2, 1, go. Let's go. Go.
The team encourages the deer to move away quickly so it doesn't focus on the collar. It also allows them to do a visual check on the health of the deer.
Excellent job.
We'll reset this trap. There's quite a bit of deer in the area, and we'll probably see on the camera deer returning in the next 30, 40 minutes. Even with us all being here, the deer just will come back just because of the numbers in this area.
So Aaron, what do you think the emerging patterns that we're seeing are?
Yeah, I think there's two clear things that we've seen. It looks like actually most of those deer have left the island at various points.
Mm-hmm.
The second thing that we've observed is that these deer have very small home ranges, meaning they have a very small area where they spend their time, where they forage, and most of those areas don't overlap. Mm-hmm. They appear quite segregated.
But what's really important to understand is those little home ranges connect together like links of a chain. And those little individual linkages create resilience in a population like white-tailed deer.
As their home ranges are impacted by climate change, the ability to move to new habitat will help the deer population to be more resilient, find food, mates, and diversify the gene pool.
Connected lands refers to the ability of wildlife to move between protected places and natural areas. That can happen in a variety of ways, whether it's creating ecological corridors, working with landowners and indigenous communities about how to better protect lands so that forests and wetlands and all the rivers can actually flow together more naturally, like they've always done. One of the things we're hoping with this research is combining it together with what we already know about wildlife mortality and roads in the area to help determine the best places to mitigate wildlife mortality by creating wildlife overpasses.
As the climate changes, species like the white-tailed deer will be looking for new home ranges. Monitoring their movement shows how the population is being impacted, and this helps Parks Canada make conservation decisions that will support other species too.
So one of the unique things about this park is its incredible biodiversity. We have some of the highest biodiversity of herptiles, of plants, of insects, of any national park in the country. So this work is critically important in understanding how we need to adapt our management practices to better address the impacts of climate change.
It's a very privileged experience to be in a cage with a deer and processing it. I'm trusting my team and the deer that we're going to do this well and safely, but just being able to handle a large wild animal is quite special. We're doing meaningful work that I think will inform management, conservation, and protection of species. So that's what gives me hope, is seeing my students think about their research in light of climate change.
One of the things that I really enjoy working with Parks Canada is that we're at the forefront of developing understanding about how the ecosystem is responding to climate change. And the work that we're doing is incredibly important because it will influence future decisions. It'll be able to allow us to protect the ecosystems and help them adapt to climate change.